from the depths of our heart, we just like to welcome Kim Kosodashi. We're so lucky to have this qualified master with us today to teach us more about Buddhism and just how to be a good person. We're very, very grateful. I think a lot of information was in the video, so you could see about Rinpoche and his great works, how he leads the Institute of Larangar and Serto Institute, and how many projects he has. He has many altruistic charitable projects. He engages in so much Dharma translation, and he teaches tirelessly across the world. Kempo is a student of His Holiness Jigme Khunso Rinpoche, who is also the master of our teacher, Chamcho Rinpoche. So we are very blessed to have the same lineage master come and teach us. Thank you.
刚才我前面念诵的这个偈颂啊，实际上是祈祷本寺释迦牟尼佛的。 它的内容就是说，在末法五百时，就显现就是度化无量无边的众生的本释迦佛，他是曾经发过500个大愿，并且我们幽咽的众生听到他的名号，就菩提道种获得不退转，所以。 我们在座的各位，从佛教的教义来讲呢，非常有缘，即僧当中，有幸听到佛的名号。So
just now I just recited a verse that is a prayer of Buddha Shakyamuni, and in this verse it said, in the 500 years of the degeneration time. Buddha Shakyamuni will emanate as a teacher to liberate and benefit infinite sentient beings. And he had made 500 great aspirations. And if we hear or we get the chance to listen to his name, then we will not we will not degenerate or withdraw from the path to enlightenment. So I think today, everyone here, because you already heard the name of Buddha Shakyamuni, I think you are all very fortunate.
今天啊，我们探讨的话题是佛教的皈依和它的功德。在座的各位呢，我想大多数应该对佛教有信心，或者说是对佛有好感的。那么首先我们要讲到皈依这个词。
And so today our topic is about Buddhist way of taking refuge and also its benefit or merit. So I think for all of you, you must have some faith or interest in Buddhism. So the first thing we're going to talk is the concept of taking refuge.
其实这个皈依呢，在佛教当中也有这个意识，还有它的这种内容，其他的有些教派当中，包括一些基督教的洗礼啊，就这些也是与此相通。
And so in Buddhism, when we talk about taking refuge, it includes a ceremony, ritual, and also its content. And also, this is also true in Christianity. You also have bathing or some kind of the ceremony for similar to taking refuge.
而佛教的这种皈依呢，实际上有很多层意思。也就是说，我们寄生当中，就是从烦恼、痛苦，或者说是轮回的这种恐惧当中呢，获得解脱，也有这样的意思。还有，不仅仅是精神当中，可能有些人就是皈依佛教，是我寄生当中的健康和解脱的话，这个内容就有点太狭隘了。更重要的。从精神开始来自生生世世很多事的这种轮回当中不痛苦而获得究竟的这种解脱就这就是佛教的皈依的真实这个含义
And when we talk about taking refuge we also have different levels of understanding or different motivationFor some people, they may just think, I want to be happy or be healthy in this life, and then they go to take refuge. And for some people, they think, oh, maybe I should get rid of all my afflictive emotions, and I want to be free from the fear in samsara, so they take refuge. And also, there are another level, which is not only just for this lifetime, but for all the lives to come. I want to be free from all afflictive emotions, all sufferings in samsara, and gain or reach the ultimate liberation. And this is the genuine motivation for us to take refuge.
其实皈依呢，在我们实践当中也有很多层的跟皈依相同的意义。只不过人们不做而已，不成为皈依而已。譬如说我们病人，他非常痛苦的时候，我们会寻找医生，这也是一种皈依。那么学生呢，他为了求学知识，寻找他的教导者，老师，这也是一种皈依。那么孩子呢？他来到这个世界的时候没有依靠的地方那么父母呢就是他的皈依同样的我们实践的男女呢在生活当中需要有一种陪伴和伴侣那么他会寻找他的家人呢这也是一种皈依
So taking refuge also can be interpreted in a worldly way. That is, but most of the time we don't put it in that way. We don't see that as a kind of a taking refuge, but you can think it in the following cases. When a patient suffers from disease, he or she wants to find a doctor. This is also kind of taking refuge in the doctor. And for students who are seeking knowledge or truth, they want to find a teacher. This is also a way for them to take refuge. And for children, because when they just come in this world, they have no other way to survive, so they have to rely on their parents. And this is also a way of taking refuge. And for men and women, and you feel lonely, you want to find a boyfriend, girlfriend, a spouse, then that's also a way for you to take refuge.
其实，皈依呢，实际上都是寻找一个安全处，依靠，一种非常怎么讲，就是有一种寻找一种安全感。我们知道，我们现在世界上的很多人呢，因为他的生活没有安全感，感情没有安全感，还有他的工作和事业没有安全感，始终都处于一种担忧和一种这种忐忑不安的心态当中，就这样的状态当中。那么在这种情况下，我们要寻找一个很可靠的依处。那么寻找可靠的依处的过程当中呢，我们会想各种各样的办法，一定要找对就是你的依靠处。这就是我们寻找皈依处。
So, because when we living in this world, we always have a feeling of insecure. We just feel, don't feel safe. We want to find security. This can be applied in our life, daily life, our relationship, our job, our career. We always feel something insecure inside. So we always have worries, anxiety. And to get rid of this kind of negative emotions, we want to find something that we can rely on and to get the feeling of security. And during the process of looking for a good thing or a good object for us to take refuge in, or rely on, we should be very careful to find a correct, a right, a qualified object or something that we can really rely on.
我们寻找安全处的时候，需要一些物质上的因素，也需要精神上的因素。依靠物质上的话，可能我们需要寻找一些住处啊。车辆啊，还有包括我们的吃的、穿的、用的当当当，就是这些呢，也是我们在生存过程当中是不可缺少的。
So when we are trying to find something secure, it can be material and also spiritual. So for the material thing.What we need is like shelter or houses or clothing and food, and all these things are indispensable for us to survive in this world.
如果这些物质上的衣橱，或者说这些资源没有的话呢，我们人类呢，很多人也很可怜的。我们知道，我们经常在十字路口看到很多的乞讨者。因为他们没有生活的保障，没有自己的一个就是很好的住处啊，或者饮食啊，在这种情况下，他不得不在就人们众所目光惦记的一些街头巷尾啊，都在漂泊流浪，就是这就是。他没有这个物质的这种保障，或者没有他的情况下呢，就是他就在人们面前漂泊。
So if we do not have enough material resources, our life could be very miserable. Because as we can see, there are a lot of people, because they lack basic living conditions, they have to wander in the street or wait at the traffic lights to ask people to give them money. This kind of life is really miserable. And so in that way, we can understand material resources are indispensable for us to survive in this world.
还有一种呢，我们需要精神上的依靠。所谓的精神上的依靠呢，就是我们有需要信仰，需要智慧，需要这种慈悲心，慈悲心。还有呢，就是有一种道德的观念，要做人的基本的这种这个人格。先生的人格当当，就这些呢，就是我们内心当中的这个益处。
And we also need a spiritual reliance, or something that we can rely spiritually, that include our faith, our wisdom, and also loving kindness and compassion, morality, and also a very virtuous personality.
如果没有精神的益处呢，也许物质的所有条件样样具足，但是我们的心呢，也很有可能就跟乞丐一样的，到处漂泊流浪，一点也不自在，每次都是处于一种郁郁痛苦、焦虑、烦恼当中，就是非常沮丧当中。那么这种人呢，虽然物质是很富裕的，但是精神呢，就是完全贫穷的，也没有安全感的。
If we do not have the spiritual reliance or something that we can rely on spiritually, we may have a very rich material life, but what inside, then we are very poor. Our spiritual life can be very poor, and we may be a beggar inside, a spiritual beggar.And we just live with a lot of anxiety, depression, and sadness.
在这种精神的这个财富呢，需要一种积累。刚开始不可能我们每个人的是什么知识都会精通的。比如说农民的话，刚开始他不会种庄稼，他逐渐通过这个学习以后，后来他才学会。那么工人呢，就是刚开始很多产品他也不会做的，他通过一段时间的学习，依靠一个老师的这种学习以后呢，他才会做到的。同样的，我们学电脑，刚开始不可能你动到的，后来通过老师的给你的这种传输呢，就是才会了解的。诸如此类的，我们实践当中的许许多多的知识呢，全部是归于一个老师，然后他给你进行传教以后呢，你才就是拥有这种知识的财产。
So when we talk about the spiritual wealth, it requires accumulation. For example, for a farmer, at first he does not know how to plant crops. So he has to learn first how to plant the seed in the field and then do everything following that. So he has to do that to learn that. And for a worker who may not be able to make any product without learning from other people, so he has to learn that knowledge. And for a student, maybe he cannot operate the computer, he has to learn that from a teacher.And this is also true for all the other things. So for any of the knowledge that we want to learn, we have to first rely on a qualified teacher, then we can start to learn that, to accumulate our spiritual wealth.
而今天我们讲的是佛教的皈依。那佛教的皈依呢，实际上是必实践的这种皈依。刚才我提到的几个实践的皈依呢，更要超生。因为佛教当中所讲到的皈依的目的，皈依的方法， 还有皈依最后得到的这种结果，这些的话呢，在我们一般的普通人的在日常生活当中，几乎都很少见。它是一种超自然的，一种超能量的，超想象的一种力量，或者说是很抽象的知识。
So today we are talking about Buddhist taking refuge, which is more supreme or more important than all, any form of worldly taking refuge. And we will talk about the goal and the approaches and also the consequences after we take refuge. This is not something everyone understands or everyone knows. It's out of imagination. Taking refuge, the effect of taking refuge is out of imagination. It's abstract. It's transcendental. So we have to learn about it and think deeply about it.